السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus, the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri Rahmatullahi Alayh.
Lesson number 832. This again is a brief understanding of some ayat of the Holy Quran, wherein Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ رَبَّكُمُ اللَّهُ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ إِلَىٰ آخِرِ الْآيَةِ. In this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining to us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of the entire universe, the world, the earth, the sky, the sea, in 6 days. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to the majestic being of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala went on the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like how it befits Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one can make any sort of intervention, or no one can go and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on behalf of somebody else unnecessarily if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not allow it to happen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the sustainer of the entire universe, so we should make the ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is not the translation of the verses. This is not the translation of the verses. Understand? This is the understanding of the verses to summarize it for us to be able to understand it. The arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the greatest thing that Allah, or the biggest thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. It is perhaps made of noor according to one narration, or it is made of beautiful emeralds according to another. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a way of everything, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, for an example, busy with the mountains or the earth or anything of that, it doesn't mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is oblivious of something else. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is busy with the huge mountains or the seas or the villages or the jungles or anything else, doesn't mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is oblivious of any other small aspect that happens. Not a leaf drops or a stone moves, but that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of it. One day a big group of people had come to the believers, and when they saw them, they were wondering that who such people are. So when the believers asked them, who are you all? He said, we are the jinnat, and we are coming with regards to the ayat that was revealed now, and we've just come out of the town to see it. So it's important for us to be able to understand this ayat, that we have to appreciate the being of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how we're supposed to be reacting to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to put ourselves forward to that one being. And that one being will make it that each one besides him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him you for us to be able to benefit from those people, insha'Allah ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is not in need of anything at any point in time. And we believers, we are always in need at every point in time. Please do keep that in mind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq and understanding. Now let us read. Subhanallahi walhamdulillahi wa la ilaha illallahu والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. Look, I have read this for every part of the sentence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give me, inshallah, a day 3 in Jannah. You also read it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you also. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from each one of us. Ameen, ameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.